Hello, this clip is being used for educational purposes. Religious freedom being lost, it is a time for choosing. A challenge to pastors from pastors.
This is not about us needing to move out of our comfort zone. This is about our comfort zone no longer existing.
Basically, there will be a cost that will have to be paid by both Christians and churches for what they believe.
If we do not take this challenge seriously, then we will continue to see the erosion of religious liberty, and that will be a travesty for the history of the United States.
I don't think the threat's been any greater since the founding of our country. Probably not far away from what drove the first immigrants to America in the first place.
Most of this is about pushing back the federal government and pushing back government in general and saying you're encroaching over the line of what ought to be a citizen's individual religious liberties.
Nobody would have thought America could have changed this much in the last 5 years. No one could have predicted this.
We would have never imagined that we would be fighting the battles that we're fighting today. You can only project with fear and trembling what the next 40 years holds for America and for Americans.
It is happening. It will continue to happen. It will heighten. There will be a price to pay.
It's only going to get more front and center. And you don't have to be a prophet to realize that. If you'll just look at what Jesus said, you know, it's not going to get easier. Period. And how we respond to that in this critical time, it's radically important.
The gateway to turnaround is a door called repentance.
If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves, I think the church has to come get on their knees before God.
We don't mourn as those without hope. We are those who follow the one who says even death is the end.
We sometimes treat this issue as though it's a brand new thing. Nobody's ever talked about this before. And here we are dealing with some situation that is entirely unique to us. That is false. Almost every scenario with which we are dealing right now has been dealt with before. And I think we just need to go back to that playbook, because here's the good news. The church is still here. One spark of revival can change an entire nation. It's happened time and time again.
The single most influential factor in the direction of the nation is the direction of our churches. And what determines the direction our churches take are what our pastors teach and preach.
The church really needs to wake up, and if the pastors, priests, and ministers don't wake up, the church can't wake up.
The most important thing that pastors could be saying right now as it pertains to religious freedom is to challenge their congregants to live their faith uncompromisingly, unapologetically.
Most pastors, ministers, priests in America, they've lived in a time where they haven't had to do this, and I think they need to discern the times and understand that they have to step up.
A small percentage of pastors get that. They see what's coming. They're willing to stand up. They're understanding it's time to stop talking about Dietrich Bonhoeffer and start being willing to be him.
You're going to have to make a decision. Choose you this day who you will serve. If it's God, serve God. If it's Baal or the kingdoms, religions, or ideas of this world, then serve him. You're going to have to make a choice. You're going to have to stand courageously, and you're going to have to speak the truth in love under the unction and power of the Spirit of God.
Pastors, that should give us something to think about. This clip can be seen in its context for free at istandsunday.com as a part of a 2-hour broadcast. I also commend to you the movie, OneGenerationAwayMovie.com, of which this clip is a part.